when you take out time to work on a movie, it shows in the production, it shows in the direction, it shows in the plot. And when you watch well-made movies, what the while, it's wonderful, it's satisfying.
This is the most useless speech I've ever seen.
This is Hawa, my boss, and she's crazy.
I sincerely thought this was what you want.
Fix it!
Nonsense. Talking shit.
Everything just little.
Leave my office now.
And that is Tunde, her boss, and he's crazy too.
I will crush you.
Fresh.
And here's my boo, my best friend, Jumoke. Don't be deceived by her looks. She's also crazy. Oh, and this is Lekon, some rich,
annoying, despicable asshole
that I should have no business with, if not...
He didn't try to kiss you, did he?
No.
What the fuck, Leah?
Anyways, my name is Leah. And I just want to be the boss.
Welcome to a new edition with me. My name is Chacha Wabara. If you're just meeting me for the first time, welcome. And to my returning subscribers and viewers, hello. Today we'll be reviewing the movie called Who is the Boss? It's an Inglot film and is a 2020 Nigerian movie that has notable actors and actresses like Sharon Onja, Blossom Chukwujekwu, Funke Akindele, Inni Dimma Okuli Osu, Bolly Lomo, Tayo Faniro, Ashegu Arinze. It was directed by Chinasa Onuzo. It's an amazing movie. Like, really, Nollywood movies are becoming wonderful. They're becoming awesome, brilliant. You know, there's some Nollywood movies that are beginning to make sense to me. I really did have an aversion to Nollywood movies because I was like, okay, they're just time wasters. But listen, the last few weeks have been illuminating because now this movie has to do with, you know, Sharon Onja working under Funke Akindele, who keeps undermining her. They work in an advertising agency, and no matter what Sharon Onja does, Funke Akindele is not impressed. Meanwhile, it's Sharon Onja's ideas and, you know, projections that the company has been using to grow. Be that, right? So Funke Akindele is of the view that she trained Sharon Onja, like in the office. So whatever Sharon Onja, the excellence, the brilliance of Sharon Onja should be attributed to her, and Sharon Onja is entitled to nothing. On the other hand, Sharon Onja is friends with Inni Dimma Okojie. She's a medical doctor, a gynecologist. And her friend keeps telling her, come girl, you need to make a move. You need to, you know, stand up to Funke Akindele and tell her that, come on, you have ideas up there. And it's your ideas that this company has been using to get lots of retainership from huge companies. And Sharon Onja is a bit timid. She's so scared of Funke Akindele and feels that, you know, there's still so much she has to learn from Funke Akindele, and she is not up to standing up to herself. As a matter of fact, she was passed over by, you know, for a promotion that she was due for, and she overheard Funke Akindele telling Tunde, who happens to be Segun Arinze, that job is not good for Sharon Onja, but someone else, and Sharon Onja wasn't just qualified for the job, was so depressed and all that, and she just kept on undermining herself. On the other hand as well, we have Blossom Chukwujekwu, who is seen as a playboy, who is from a rich home, family friend to Inni Dimma Okojie, and he owns a theater. Sharon Onja has been coerced by her friend to open her own company and get jobs. So this company now, you know, competing with our own, you know, the company where she works, you know, where Funke Akindele and she works, you know, Apex. Meanwhile, they want her to get her boss, that is Sharon Onja. She's the CEO, she's doing an under G move, having one company by the side, working for another company, that now is, you know, those two companies are competing against each other. And this big company where she's working, now sees that her company, of course they don't know that it's her own, you know, as a threat. And she's like, so this big company sees that my little company as a threat, so that means that actually I'm worth something, that means that actually there's something good about, you know, my skills, my talent, and everything. So that means actually there's something good about me. You know, she had that complex, like nothing. So Blossom Chukwujekwu was always playing, she's an actor, was always playing her CEO, and they were closing deals. Aside that story, Blossom Chukwujekwu was a rich boy who had made so much money initially, and so, you know, he could walk the path, look the path, speak the path, and he was used to, you know, going for presentations to get a contract or to get a brief or something like that. So along the line, those two became romantically linked. It's an easygoing movie, a movie that's relaxing. I kept laughing and all that. My kids joined in and all. But what I saw about the movie was that it got progressively wonderful. It was easy. It was engaging. I loved the romance. I loved, you know, the office scenes. I loved how Funke Akindele played the character of an overbearing boss who would always look down at her subordinate. How Funke Akindele's boss, Tunde Asegun Arize, would lay off an employee at will to serve his interest, you know, because most bosses we know are selfish. He played that part to the hill. I love Blossom Chukwujekwu. This guy keeps growing on me every day. And funny enough, I've been seeing a lot of his movies recently. He's so brilliant in his movie. I loved Inni Dima Okojie, right? She has so much to bring to the table. I loved, you know, the sisterly friendship between these two girls, Sharon Onja and Dima Inni Okojie. It was real. You could feel the friendship. You could feel it. Even if they had not met each other, you know, outside of the screen, they really played it properly. It was amazing. It was a movie that I had no regrets watching, and it was engaging. I think it was with Who Is the Boss that I moved on to watching Black Rose. The movies I've been watching these days, awesome, wonderful. And this movie is amazing. Even, you know, the concluding part of the movie was wonderful. At some point, I didn't even want the movie to end. I wish, you know, they had really developed the romance part no more, you know, putting more time into it, because what I saw, I liked. Okay, so I'm going to be rating the movie a 9/10. That's because romantic side of me wishes that movie was longer than what I was seeing, and the romantic side was a bit longer. But in all, the movie was perfect. Lighting, everything about the movie was wonderful. Initially, I was getting somewhat disappointed, like, what is this movie all about? Especially when I saw that party, initial party, when it was in Dima Okojie's birthday, and Blossom Chukwujekwu called her over that they had a party for her. So I was just looking at the party scene. I was trying to understand what it was all about, but after some time the movie picked up and it became beautiful. I loved watching that movie. I wouldn't even mind watching the movie a second time. That's how beautiful the movie is. Okay, so which brings my movie review to an end. I hope you subscribe and you can see more of my movie reviews, you know, up there, Chinese, Korean, and Nigerian. I hope you have a wonderful time. Till I see you next time, bye.